Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be spending some time on the EM test solution for IEC 61000-4-8, which is an immunity test standard for power frequency magnetic fields. We're going to spend more time on the short duration test of IEC 61000-4-8. However, the same equipment can be used for the continuous field test as well. The equipment that we're going to be using for today's video is going to be the EM Test MFT 100 magnetic field transformer and the MFC 1000 1 meter coil for magnetic field testing. You'll also notice later we'll show the Fluke 355, which can be used to measure the current going through our coil. During today's video, we're going to be using models MFT 100-120 and MFC 1000.1. For the difference in particular models, you can go ahead and reference the data sheet on the product pages, which I'll put in a link in the description below for. Let's go ahead now and let's spend some time on the EM Test MFT 100. Here's the MFT 100 magnetic field transformer. This transformer can provide continuous field levels from 80 amps per meter to 100 amps per meter and short duration levels as high as 1,200 amps per meter. It can provide 50 or 60 hertz frequency fields, which will be determined by the input power. Let's go ahead now and let's walk through some of the different connections on the unit, as it can be a little confusing. Looking at the side of the unit, we have two different series of connections. The top two connections, the black and the blue terminals, are connected to the power source. Just below that, we have a second NEMA type connection, and that's going to be the control power required for the MFT 100 to run. Now, if you have looked out there and you do see there's two different variations on the MFT 100, a 120 and a 230, we are using the 120 for today's video. And then finally, on the right side of the unit, coming out of the top of the transformer, we have our cables, which will connect to our antenna. Let's go ahead now. Let's take a look at some of the documentation relating to magnetic field testing, which describes the characteristics of the equipment as well as the setup in a little more detail. Here you're going to find the data sheet for magnetic field testing, and this is the beginning of the information that relates to the MFT 100. You can see we have a diagram on the left that labels the different connections on the transformer, and then to the right of that we have our transformer factor. Now looking just below that, we have a graph reflecting the H field and AC voltage levels for both the antenna and the corresponding H field. This is particularly useful when you're looking to determine what the input voltage needs to be to achieve a certain field level. Taking a look just below that, we have a couple notes down there. As the notes indicate, to achieve greater than 750 amps per meter, it is necessary to have a voltage source greater than 115 volts. And this is illustrated on the graph as well. However, it is certainly something you want to be aware of. Let's go ahead now and scroll down to the next page and take a look at the two different setups and how they can be used with the transformer. All right, so taking a look, there's two different test setups which are commonly used with our current transformer. The first is using a variac with the corresponding transient generator. With this setup, the transient generator is used as the control unit and provides the test routines which are commonly accessed from the front of the system. The second setup is using a programmable power source. In the image provided for the setup, we have our NetWave 7. Other sources can be used as well, so long as they meet the power requirements. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the verification. All right, now we're on page 24. Section 2.3, which is the verification required for IEC 61000-4-8. You can see we're kind of midway down the page. We have a table that's particularly helpful. There we have our field strength in amps per meter and current values in amps based upon the 1 meter by 1 meter standard coil, which the MFC 1000 series conforms to. For our video, we're interested in 1,000 amps per meter.
So we would need to measure roughly 1,150 amps through our coil. You can see a brief setup overview just below the table, how that might look, and we'll probably show that to you here as well a little later on in the video. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at our MFC1000 and the necessary connections you're going to need to make.
Here's the MFC1000.1 1 meter by 1 meter coil. This coil can be used for power frequency magnetic field testing to IEC 61000-4-8, impulse magnetic field testing to IEC 61000-4-9, and damped oscillatory magnetic field testing for IEC 61000-4-10. The MFC1000.1 has freestanding elements which hold the antenna, as opposed to the MFC1000, which the elements are connected to a base on rollers. Let's go ahead now and take a little closer look at the part of the antenna where the connections are made. Here's the connection element for our 1 meter coil. You can see we have two different series of connections, a 4mm and a 14mm. There's two different 4mm banana jack style connections that are black and blue on the right, and then we have the two larger 14mm connectors on our left. The 14mm connections are only used with the MFT100 for IEC 61000-4-8 testing for power frequency magnetic fields. The parallel sets of connectors on the right are limited to 30 amps per meter and are typically only used for testing to IEC 61000-4-9 and IEC 61000-4-10. Keep in mind there's also specific requirements for the cabling and how it's connected to the antenna, which needs to be followed in order to be sure you're compliant. Let's go ahead now and let's get the system connected and take a look. Here's the complete setup from EM Test for IEC 61000-4-8 testing. You can see we have our magnetic field transformer directly in front of our coil. That's just to make it a little easier to see the whole complete setup when we're recording. There's a couple different connections that you're going to want to be aware of. The first of which is those black and blue banana jack style connectors, which are going to go to our power source. And then from our magnetic field transformer, we have our cables going to our magnetic field coil. What you will notice is we do have our current meter clamped around the coil. This is going to allow us to measure the current and ensure that we reach the threshold levels relating to specific magnetic field strength requirements. All right, that should just about complete the video today on the EM test solution for magnetic field testing in accordance with IEC 61000-4-8. We began the video by talking about the MFT100 magnetic field transformer. Then we moved to the MFC1000. And then we talked briefly through some of the different capabilities, connections, and the setup. We hope this video has been useful, and please keep us in mind if you ever need to rent any magnetic field immunity test equipment.